Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta back with you for another lecture of Dental Paathshala. In today's video, we are going to talk about the repair and regeneration. Today's video, we are going to talk about the GTR, guided tissue regeneration. How the tissue is regenerated. What do you mean by regeneration? What do you mean by repair? What do you mean by new attachment? And what is a reattachment? So all these things we are going to familiarize with. And GTR, we are going to see the plus points of GTR, the minus points of GTR, and what is GTR. So let's jump into more details about GTR. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon. That way you get a notification as soon as I release a video lecture, and lecture will come to your mobile phone. So talking about the repair and regeneration, now what do you mean by repair and regeneration? So the last video we have already talked about that if my gene is torn, if I have a torn genes, and or if I have a hole in my gene, now what do I do? I have two options. One option, if the hole is so small that it can be repaired, that I can take it to the tailor and the same colored cloth, he can put it and he can make it as a patchwork. Now, this is called the repair. Repair is in which I am taking it to the tailor and I am just correcting it. I am correcting the defect which already existed. Regeneration is if the gene is like gone and I cannot wear it. It is gone from such an area that I cannot wear it. So in such a scenario, and I want to wear this specific jeans, I have a award show coming up or I have a shoot, so I have to wear this specific jeans only. So what do? I take the cloth, I go to market, take the same quality cloth, or if I go to the showroom and if I go to the same specific brand and I buy the same quality, the same color, same size jeans, so that would be a regeneration. Or if I want to get it stitched, then buy the same cloth and get it stitched. So regeneration is starting from the scratch. It is the natural renewal. It is the exact renewal of what was already existed, of what was the defect. So regeneration is basically the renewal, natural renewal of a structure. Now this renewal is from the cells which were already causing the growth of specific substance, specific tissue. For example, the PDL fibers, for example, generating the osteoblast, generating the odontoblast. So all these things are starting from the scratch. So these, we are forming these cells, and these cells are again forming the PDL, these cells are again forming the junctional epithelium. So starting from the scratch, the same cells which were making before, which were making these structures, so these cells are making the new structure which resemble as it is from the structure. So it is the same type of growth from the same type of tissues, growth from the same precursor cells. So regeneration is the natural renewal of the structure produced by the growth and differentiation of the new cells. Now these cells were the same cells which the past tissue were making. So the previously the tissues were making the cells which the tissue were making, these are the same kind of cells. Now what do you mean by repair then? Repair is correcting it, right? So repair is healing. So this is healing by the scar. So this is restoring the continuity of the diseased structure, restoring the continuity of the diseased marginal gingiva and re-establishing. We are establishing again because I have a patch, right? I have a hole in my jeans and I can't wear this jeans with a hole. So I have to get it repaired. So the same way, re-establishing the normal structure, re-establishing a normal jeans. So same way, re-establishing a normal gingival sulcus, which was previously. But it is now existing. This repair exists on the diseased structure. This repair exists on the defect. So repair is when we are healing this defect. Regeneration is we are reforming all of the tissues all over again. So GTR, guided tissue regeneration, would be a regeneration, as the name suggests. This is a regeneration. We'll talk about it. Don't worry. Don't get hurried. And repair we have is the SRP, scaling and root planning. So whatever mild tissue structure we have lost, we can repair it. Curettage, flap surgeries, gingivoplasty, all these things we can, with the help of repair, all these structures can come back to normal, but not in the state which was previous. It can come back to normal, but not in the previous state. So the tissues are not going to be same like as they were previously. So we have two new terms. One is the new attachment, then the reattachment. Now, I have always been telling you, go for the term. So you will know about, you will have all about the idea what it is telling. New attachment means, it means that it is more like a regeneration, right? Because new attachment, we are giving a new attachment. So we are trying to get a new attachment to the tissues which were previously diseased. So the genes which I want, which I am getting now, will be exact replica, will be exact copy of the genes which I had. Basically, the structures which are lost, we are replacing the structures which were previously lost due to the disease. So, if I have to make a junctional epithelium, I have to make a sulcular epithelium, that means there was previously a junctional epithelium, there was previously a sulcular epithelium, and I am giving a new attachment to it. So, basically this is formation of new thing only, but previously the new thing had something on the other. For example, there was a one wall defect, and I've always been telling you, if there is a one wall defect, that means only one wall is present, right? If one wall is present, then we have to take this wall, and on the barren land, I'm going to reconstruct a new building. So this would be a kind of a new attachment. This would be like giving a new attachment. That means previously there was a room. Now we are constructing a new room, not in a barren land, but which was previously a room. So like that, new attachment is trying to give a new attachment in a previously diseased condition. Embedding the new PDL fiber into the cementum and attaching it to the gingival epithelium, attaching it to the tooth surface, which was diseased, which was denuded by the disease. And reattachment is giving an attachment, but not in a condition where there was previously a disease. Just like that, repair was like that. Repair is like, if I want to get it altered, like my genes was a long genes. I bought a genes and it was a long genes. I want to get it altered to my ankle size, right? So like that, I have to get it altered. That means I have to get it trimmed. So that would be a reattachment. That means there was no previously disease. There was no patch. There was no hole in the gene. So reattachment would be, there was no previously disease, but still we are giving adaptation of the new fibers to the sulcus. So after any surgical detachment, after any periapical lesion treatment, after any endoperio problems, we give a new attachment. So this would be a passive adaptation of the gingival fibers to the sulcus. Or I can say reattachment is the repair of the root not previously exposed to the pocket, such as a surgical detachment of the tissues, or following any traumatic injury. After any traumatic injury, if I am repairing anything, that would go to a reattachment. Now, epithelial adaptation is a close apposition. Epithelial adaptation. That means adapting to the epithelial surface. So there is a close approximation of the epithelium to the tooth surface. So we are adapting the epithelial, we are getting the epithelial close to the tooth surface, and we are not gaining any height of the gingival fiber attachment, we are just taking the epithelium close to the tooth surface. So like we studied, if you remember, we have studied NAP, new attachment procedure. So this was given in the US, this was given by the US Corps. So if you remember, in the new attachment procedure, like that, we have laser assisted NAP. So we have laser assisted new attachment procedure. So we are giving a new attachment with the help of a laser. So basically the flap is raised, and after that a laser is passed onto the bone surface to do the recountering. So NDAG laser is most commonly used for this procedure, and this is used in case of a chronic periodontitis. So this laser, because there is still a lot of research going on this LANAP, but it results in the new attachment. It is not confirmed yet, but there are so many articles, so many research going on right now on this topic, and this results in the new attachment and the new periodontal regeneration. So talking about our main important topic, which is the GTR. Now, what do you mean by GTR? As the name suggests, I have been always telling you, go for the name itself. So, GTR is guided tissue regeneration. That means guiding the tissues to regenerate. So, GTR is basically a membrane which we place. Okay, but that doesn't mean that this membrane is doing the growth. This membrane is not doing the growth, as the name suggests, guiding the tissues. So, we are guiding the tissues. So, basically, as a response of the normal healing process which is going on in the body, we are utilizing this normal healing process and we are guiding these tissues to regenerate. Are you getting my point? That means, see, whatever the periodontal structure is lost, we are regenerating this periodontal structure. We are not giving any bone graft from outside, but the normal healing structure, we are giving a path to the normal healing structure. We are guiding basically. So we are telling these cells that this is the way you should go. And if you should go this way, then you will reach to your destination very fast. So like that, we are guiding the tissues. So like how my teachers guide me, like how I guide you. So this is the same way. This is the GTR. We are guiding the tissues to regenerate so that they can reach to their aim as fast as possible. So regenerating the lost periodontal structures is re-augmented via selective cell tissue, selective tissue repopulation of the periodontal wound. I know it is going above your head. Now it will. You will understand. I have a story to tell you to understand the GTR better. Now what happens is, a girl takes up a seat in a dental college, okay, and there are four guys. First guy is the epithelium, second guy is the connective tissue, third guy is the bone, and fourth guy is the periodontal ligament. Now what happens, these guys, there is a hot girl, okay, which takes up a seat in a dental college. Now all of the boys in the college are just behind this girl, and they want to propose this girl, and they start proposing. So but she's keep on looking for a good match so that she can get settled with a really nice man. So first epithelial comes and proposes this girl. Now epithelium, his main work is defense. As we all know by now, if you have been watching the videos, you know that the work of epithelium, we have already studied inflammation, we have already studied everything. If you remember gingiva, so there was a war story in the gingiva which we studied. So the upper layer which were defensive, so if you remember all that, so basically the purpose of gingiva is the defense. So this epithelium cell is basically the gunda, the huge man with the biceps, so who is into all the fights. So he comes, so the first guy who has the more guts, he comes and he proposes this girl. But if this girl says yes, that means the couple are going to be the long junctional epithelium. Because if it combines, the healing combines with the epithelium, then it will make a long junctional epithelium, not a normal junctional epithelium, a long junctional epithelium. That means the girl will also become like a gunda. The girl will also go into the fights and she'll ruin her career. So epithelium should be stopped. We should stop this epithelium in order for the betterment of this girl. So preserving this love space in the girl's heart, we have to preserve it. This and so that the correct guy, the correct man she should meet and they should fall in love. So we have to protect this, we have to prevent this epithelium from meeting this girl. Okay, so I am preparing a barrier so that this guy, this epithelium doesn't meet the girl. Also there comes then the second guy, which is the connective tissue. Now connective tissue's role is basically the formation of the matrix. So he does all of the projects, he is into the project work and do, you know, all of the takes part in the function. And also this connective tissue guy comes and he tells that I'll help you with the college projects. And as it actually acts as the functions and the formation of all the cells. But if it gets pissed off or if it gets angry, it causes resorption or destruction or connective tissue adhesion. So also this connective tissue should be stopped for meeting this girl. And then comes the third guy, the bone. Now bones is the strongest, richest, handsome dude of the college. And bone has money, fame, following, fan. You know, he is good with girls and he uses the girls. So he is not good. Girls, he uses girls like toys. And once he is done with the girls, he just throw them, dump them. So girls, but actually girls want more loving and more caring guys. Not like Bone, but he has got fame, fan following and all everything. So Bone, actually it causes Enkai losses. If he meets the girl, either it is going to stick to the girl, it is going to do Enkai losses, or it is going to destroy the girl's future, also destroy the girl's hurt also. So it will do resorption, root resorption. So Bone should also be stopped. So the next guy is the hero. Now he is the good guy, which is the PDL. And finally a guy comes who's good at heart, who's down to earth, who's loving, who's caring, and who has money also. So girls always like a guy like PDL, but he doesn't show off to everybody. So they don't know that this kind of guy exists also. But these guys are more like a calm kind of guys. So this PDL is finally the guy who has pyar, paisa, you know, sab kuch. So he asks. He can also get the things done. He can ask the other guys to get the things done. And if once he fall in love with this girl, he is going to give her everything. So it can also generate new PDL. It can also generate new fibers. It can also generate new connective tissue, epithelium, bone. So basically, we guide the girl not to meet all of these guys. And we have to make sure that the girl meets the perfect guy, which is the PDL. So this is the barrier. Which barrier we place is called the GTR. So we are not meeting this healing process to meet the epithelium, connective tissue as well as bone. We are just letting the PDL uniting with this healing process so that they unite and then they form everything and there is flowers, there is roses, there is love in the air, so there is everything. So this is the work of the GTR. Now that if I tell you, GTR, it regenerates the lost periodontal structure via selective cells and tissue repopulation. So only selective cells and tissues of the PDL are regenerating by using a membrane. This membrane can be resorbable. That will come to in the classification. So that we'll know about in the classification. This membrane can be a resorbable membrane or a non-resorbable membrane. But basically, using this membrane as a barrier, we are excluding the epithelial cells, connective tissue cells, and the bone cells. And we are letting this PDL fiber forming these new structures, new cells, new tissues around the tooth surface so that there is a new epithelialization, so that there is a new regeneration. So this is the whole concept of the GTR. And this PDL, when it meets the girl, so meets male. Male is a Hindi word which means that there is a meeting. So there is a union, I can say. So this male was given by the Melcher. So you can remember it as male for Melcher. So Melcher was a guy who gave this concept about putting a membrane as a barrier and basically distracting all the epithelial connective tissue and bone cells, separating all these cells and letting the PDL cells to regrow, to repopulate and to do the regeneration process. So this concept was given by the Melcher concept. And the first GTR membrane was placed by the Gottlob. So Gottlob first used this GTR membrane for controlled tissue. See, we can say this controlled tissue regeneration because there is we are controlling all these tissues. And only a specific tissues are regenerating in the GTR. So this is providing a new attachment by placing a barrier for a better result. The new attachment thereby occurs and only the PDL cells are going to repopulate on the tooth surface. So there is going to be new attachment, new fibers, new connective tissue, new epithelium and new bone. And thereby we are giving a potential to regenerate. So there is a regeneration process which is happening by the excluding all the negative cells. So all the negative guys we are excluding by placing a barrier and also by creating a sufficient space also because we are not letting this girl fall into any of the wrong guy. So we are making this space in our heart for a right man. So thereby also we are creating a space to allow the perfect guy to come and fall in love, to formate the desired tissue, and by protecting and stabilizing the clot. So this is how the GTR works. It gives the preference to the cell. It is giving the preference to the guy, which is important, which has the potential to regenerate. So thereby, which has the potential to make her future, to make her happy. So thereby, the preference cells are coming and they are regenerating and providing the new growth. So where in all cases we can use this GTR? Now you cannot use this GTR for the horizontal defects. Why? Because if there is a horizontal bone loss, then it cannot grow like this. So it has to be an angular defect, so that when we are placing this GTR, we are not letting all of these cells coming and reuniting this tooth surface. We are only letting the PDL fibers to grow. See, when we are placing this GTR, suppose this is a bony defect and we are placing this GTR, and we are not letting all of these cells to repopulate. We are letting only the PDL fibers, which are attached to the tooth, and we are letting this PDL fibers only to attach to the tooth surface. So that is how we are using this indication of the GTR. Is basically we use it for the infrabony pockets. So for both deep and narrow pockets we can use it, and also for the circumferential defects. For class 2 defects we use this GTR, because class 3 defect, no, if we talk about the one wall defect or the class 3 focation defect, then there is extensive bone loss which is happening for all these defects. Now this defects we have to go for the resective surgical procedure, which we have already covered, because we cannot preserve, we cannot regenerate, like how we have talked about in case of a one wall defect, there is only a one wall is present in the whole room. Now we cannot reconstruct the whole room based on this, only on this one wall. If there are two walls, then it's okay, then we can still try, we can manage, but not on the basis of one wall defect. So like that, if there is a class 3 focation involvement, then also we cannot do the regeneration process, then we have to go for the resective processes. Also we can also use this GTR for the ridge augmentation, basically where we want to grow things, repair of the episectomy defects, and also for root coverage, like root resection, a root recession. Also we can use this repair of any osseous defect with failing, if implants are failing, along with that we can use, and we can also use with immediate implants if we want to place, if we want to do the osseous filling around the immediate implant, then also we can use the GTR. So contraindication is basically the poor oral hygiene. If the patient cannot maintain the hygiene, then there is no use of doing any regenerative procedure, because if patient only cannot maintain the things, then there is going to be a poor prognosis for all of the perio things. So if there is any one wall intrabony defect, that then also we cannot use it. I have explained it. Any premolar focation we cannot use. Multiple adjacent defects we cannot use. And any advanced defect with minimal amount of remaining periodontium is there. Any advanced defect we cannot use this, because regenerative procedure only can be done while we are at the moderate stage. When we are at the falling stage, when everything is going to be destroyed anyhow, when there is poor prognosis, then there is no use using the regenerative procedure, because anyhow this is going to fail and it's not going to work. So better that we go for resective for all these kind of procedures, and also in that case of any inadequate zone of attached gingiva. See, all of the flap surgeries except apically periodontal flap, as well as for the vestibular procedures, all of the flap surgeries, if there is not adequate width of attached gingiva, we cannot use. This is contraindicated. All the surgeries are contraindicated. Why? Because we have already talked about, right? If this is the marginal gingiva, then we have the attached gingiva, right? So if there is not much of attached gingiva, then what happens is, suppose if there is less, then it is going to stretch it, then it is going to pull it, and there will be more of recession actually, if there is inadequate loss of attached gingiva, if there is inadequate the zone of attached gingiva, because whatever we are doing it is going into gutter. So there is no use. If there is inadequate zone of attached gingiva, then whatever procedure we are going, it is going into gutter. So there is no use of doing all the procedures. So there is gain in a new attachment, and the donor site we don't require necessarily, except for the CT connective tissue graft we require. So, but the main disadvantage is that if we want to remove the membrane, then we need a second surgery. And GTR is an expensive procedure, and it is a technically sensitive, technically demanding procedure. Not everyone can place the GTR membrane, because only a good periodontist or only a periodontist knows how to do it better way. And it is also an expensive procedure. And there are high chances of bacterial contamination also when we are doing any kind of surgery. So, talking about the materials we used as a GTR membrane, according to Gottlob, who used these GTR for the first time. So, we have three generations. The first generation is the non-resorbable, which we require a second surgical procedure. We have to remove this membrane because it doesn't resorb on its own. The second one is bioresorbable, and the third generation is bioresorbable with the growth factors. Now, non-resorbable is like a millipore. First one is the millipore filter, and also it consists of only the PTFE. So, first thing you need to remember for the first generation for the non-resorbable is PTFE, EPTFE, which is the expanded polytetrafluoroethylene. Now, EPTFE, it comes in a Gore-Tex. So, we have a brand name as the Gore-Tex, and which comes in EPTFE. So, that is the expanded polytetrafluoroethylene. Also, there is EPTFE with a titanium reinforced. So, also we have expanded polytetrafluoroethylene with the titanium meshwork and non-porous expanded polytetrafluoroethylene, as well as we have titanium membrane in non-resorbable. So, this titanium membrane or this titanium meshwork, this is basically the high strength and high rigidity, and it has actually the ability to withstand high temperature, and also it is corrosion resistant because it is made up of titanium, and it is less susceptible for the bacterial contamination if we compare it with the absorbable membrane. So, the second generations we have is the natural bioresorbable. We have the natural as well as the synthetic. So, natural we have the collagen. Collagen comes in so many brands. It comes as Biomed, it comes as BioGuide or ParoGuide, as well as the Tissue Guide. Tissue Guide, I have seen Tissue Guide. Tissue Guide is a really nice collagen GTR, and also the oxidized cellulose we have. We have the connective tissue graft. We can take the connective tissue graft and we can use it as the GTR also. See, these bioresorbables, the second generation graft, are really nice, and we don't require any second surgery to remove this graft, and also patient acceptance is very good. If we are taking the connective tissue graft from the patient and we are placing this graft, so there is a good acceptance of the patient. We don't have to again go back for the second surgery, because if we are going for a second surgery, see, there are chances that whatever we have regenerated, we may damage also. So, this is tissue friendly. Also, it enhances the tissue coverage. It resists the microbial colonization. It prevents the bacterial contamination. But also, everything comes with the disadvantages, I have been telling you, because it is difficult in handling. First of all, for connective tissue, we have to make a second site also surgical. So, this is also this is difficulty in handling. The visibility of the material is also poor, and it can collapse also. As far as I know, collagen is the best material to use as GTR. We commonly use this collagen material. So, this collagen material, it has two parts. It has the open microstructure and the partial occlusive membrane. I don't think so, as a BDS you require that much. So, it has, and partially it has the open microstructure. So, which is the 90% of the porous part. So, which allows all of the growth. Which allows all of the epithelial cells, which is supporting the epithelial migration. So, these are the 90% porous cells. And also, we have the partially occlusive membrane, which is 30% porous, which is high in density, which is basically acting as the barrier, which prevents the other cells, which prevent the epithelial cells, bone cells, like that connective tissue cells. So, basically, this collagen membrane is a natural membrane, and we frequently use this collagen membrane. And is a bioresorbable membrane. Synthetic, we have polylactic acid, and polylactic acid comes in Atrizop, Guidor, Resolt, so like that. And polygalactine, also we have the polygalactine 910, so it comes in the vicryl mesh, or there is a combination also for PGA, which is the polygalactine, as well as for the polylactic acid. The third generation comes with the growth factors itself. So there is also resorbable membrane along with the growth factor, so that there is enhanced repair region. So there is enhanced regeneration which is occurring. So Mina be classified this also with the resorbable as well as the non-resorbable. So basically these growth factors are the recent generation, which are very nice because they have inbuilt growth factors also. So there is a high density, there is a high, like there is less time required because already it is built with a growth factor. So the regeneration is very fast in this. So guys, once we have placed this GTR, once the new generation, once the regeneration of the PDL, there is a periodontal tissues regeneration occurs, then how to check for the success of the GTR? How do we know that the regeneration occur? We can take the radiograph, we can also re-enter, we can do the surgical re-entry while we are removing the second membrane if in case we are using non-resorbable. And if we have to go for the second surgery and we have to remove this GTR, then also we can check. We can also check through the probing depth, through the probe, and in case you can extract the tooth, section the tooth, and you can check it, the histological evaluation, which is used for the study purpose, not used for the patient purpose. So this is all about the GTR procedure. This is the guided tissue regeneration. This is the regenerative procedure. Now you know that what is reattachment, what is new attachment, what is basically the GTR procedure, and why do we use this GTR procedure, how this GTR procedure works, who gave this GTR concept. Now you are familiarized with all the terms. I hope that I have made it easier for you to understand the GTR, because GTR is a very complex topic. For in my BDS days, it was very difficult for me to understand. So I have made an attempt to make it easier for you to understand. And if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you feel that you have learned something new today, then go ahead and hit the comment box, because this helped me to help you skyrocket your career and knowledge while you stay at home with your family.